left the door of the drama room open.
Oh, right. Well,
unless you want to walk through the school.
No.
Get nervous before talk about any public.
Yeah, let's read off.
Yes, I it's unbelievable.
Really, really excited to be involved in the project. We're delighted to have been selected, so thank you very much. And I'm really, really keen that we don't just focus on those core academic subjects, but that the students leave us as rounded individuals. It's a fantastic way for them to be able to express themselves and, as you say, develop social confidence. So I know that this project is going to be a huge success for our students, and that they're very, very excited about it.
Fantastic.
We're delighted to have you here at Woodside.
Well, it's, I hope you say the same thing when I am leaving, you know?
All good.
We're at Frederick Bremer School in East London, and Rudolph is ready to just go on to speak to 180 Year 9s. How are you feeling?
Nervous.
You've done this about 100 times, by the way, and you're still nervous.
It's a time like this, you want to do all sorts of things. You want to go to the toilet, you want to read, you want to...
Good morning,
good morning
all. Good morning. Say that again.
Where's the bottle of whiskey?
The bottle of whiskey. Hang on just a minute. I turned it into water. A very simple question. Any of you all know where I was born, where I came from, my background? Any? There's a hand up in the back. Trinidad. Your parents from Trinidad? No, I would imagine you all at the age of 14. At 14, I was running the drama class when my teacher's absent in what is equivalent to elementary school, is equivalent to your comprehensive school. So my love for the theater started very, very early. And the moral to that little simple story is that to succeed in whatever you want to do, you have to lay the foundations very early. And this is not to say that you shouldn't have fun. I enjoyed myself in Trinidad as a youngster, but having said that, my focus was in the theater. And here I am today, having laid the foundation and having made those sacrifices to achieve what I've achieved, and there's still a long way to go. And the difficulty that I know you all are facing, to me it was a lot easier growing up in Trinidad as a 12-year-old, as a 13-year-old, as a 14-year-old. I didn't have the distraction of internet and things like that. I made my own, we made our own toys. You know, the scooters, we made our own scooters. You know, we tops, we were always outside creating things. I'm not painting a picture for you all to just up your bags and baggage and go and live in Trinidad. That's not the reason why I'm telling you this. It's just to give you an idea of what my background was like. Back in 1970, I launched it in Brixton. And the reason for that is that there was a lot of problems, some of you all or your parents might have told you, back in the 70s and the 60s, the kids were being alright, you okay, son? If anything at all, you come and call me and I'll come and sort it out. Yes, there was a lot of problem in the Brixton area. The kids approached me and said that.
And sometimes too, depends on what takes place. It sometimes too is quite moving when a kid would say something or do something that is fantastic, and you think, wow, would that kid have had the opportunity had this been the award ceremony or the drama award? Would this kid would have had the opportunity to do something like that or say something like that? And suddenly you see the confidence grew, and that is something that would stay with her for the rest of her life, you know. And so when you get little stories like that, it really is, you know, it's heartwarming that you feel that we are all doing an excellent job. It's got to be genuine, because it's you've got to be doing it for them, not for yourself. Is it real? Is it me? It's happening too. That kids are responding that way. And at times it's awesome, I suppose, or it's humbling. At times a humbling experience.
I relaunched it about 3 years ago in the Millfield Arts Center, and your school, I believe, came second last year.
The idea is that you get together in groups of five. You write, direct your own 10-minute piece. Sometime within the next week or two, you'll have a mentor, someone that you might recognize or you should recognize from television, who would come and work with the groups for maybe over a period of 2 or 3 weeks.
But it's all yours. It's a great day at Millfield Arts Center. We are hoping that next year to move to a bigger theater, maybe Theater Royal Stratford East, or who knows, maybe in the West End, depending on what sort of level we get to next year.
If I could relive one moment in my life,
yeah. What will it be?
It's a difficult question, because there are so many exciting moments. One of the greatest satisfaction that I get is visiting schools. And there have been very moving and fantastic moments in schools that I've visited in inner London. And those are moments that I cherish. I cherish the moments that I spend with you all today. Those are moments that I, you know, they're priceless. They're priceless. It's, you know, that's as close as I can get to telling you, you know, the moments that I would, you know, I relive.
Once I thought, am I engaging them? Are they engaged?
Thank you.
Oh, you're fantastic. Thank you.
Thank you.
You can't breathe yet.
Falling in love. Oh, 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 oh.
about just after 4 o'clock this morning, and I left home at 5:30. Now it's just coming up to 7:30. Just to see their faces, their reaction, to see how to witness how creative they are. In itself is adrenaline, wanting to do something with their lives, because at the end of the day, that's what it is, to encourage them to do something with their lives. You know, it would be such a joy to see schools from various countries competing against each other. But a camaraderie, you know, it could be a school from America, school from Nigeria, school from Ghana, school from the Caribbean, kids from the Caribbean. The thought of all of them in one big building, just having fun and being very creative, to me is the ultimate. We are heading for the Frederick Bremner School.
Is it in the Urswick school again today?
No. No, that's... So it was an advantage having that extra time, having ended up in the wrong school.
Here I am, a year older, which makes me what?
41.
Hey man, you deserve a shake of the hand.
Thank you.
All right. No, answer me. Do I look like a 52-year-old? Not really. So why you said 52 then?
If your main thought is money and fame, what happens when you're out of work and there is no money? I bless you all and thank you very much for listening.
When you hear people say that, you know, they get a high, that's how I get, just to see the kids motivated, as I said, and